Good morning, everyone. Namaste. Namaste. I am hoping that my internet will work all the way through today. I am sending positive vibes. We've been having some challenges. I don't know why, but I'm going to set my intention today for a wonderful internet experience. So I am on and I'm going to start class in just a minute. But I just want to make sure everybody can hear me okay, see me okay, hear and see me. That the audio is loud enough for you. So I'm just gonna wait 1 second to make sure everybody is set on. I do a lot of like gawking because the window is only so big. I know this is a bit of a stretch, but if you happen to, hey, no pun intended, bit of a stretch, but if you happen to have, if you happen to have a block, please gather that today. Let's see, video has stopped. Okay, anybody? Anybody else having video issues? It looks like mine's working right now. I haven't gotten anything on my end, so I'm just checking in on some comments. But it here it looks okay. But that could change. So I'm going to do the very best I can, and if for some reason like my video stops, I will probably just do a pre-recorded and then put that on the Facebook page. So we're gonna go with it. So good morning. I picked a card this morning. Oh, working again. Excellent, Patricia. Woo! All right, put it up there. So it's funny because I picked one of these cards as a theme today, and the one I picked is I speak and think positively. I listen to what I say. And if I hear myself using negative or limiting words, I change them. And this really couldn't be a more poignant time to be thinking of the words that you are saying. And right now, it is so easy to get caught up in the negativity, in complaining, in venting. In focusing in on just the things that aren't working right now. And I know I've been struggling with that a lot from just my own life to the global world to all of the craziness that's going on. It's really hard not to get sucked into that funnel. And there is a place for it. I think it's important that we validate what we're experiencing, but also try not to let that rule your day and rule your thought process, because ultimately we don't have control of everything. And the only control that we can have is our mind, as far as if we choose to have positive thoughts or negative thoughts. So maybe for today, you can kind of, and this week, it could be a nice lesson and a nice exercise is see how you're talking, kind of be this witness to how you are communicating with others and with yourself. And if you start noticing this kind of negative or this darkness. Maybe see how you could switch that thought, switch the synapses in your brain to think more positively. And maybe a little fake it till you make it has to happen. But this is a good reminder for me, and this is an exercise I'm definitely going to work with because I've noticed that it's getting a little hard lately to be grateful and look at all these wonderful moments that we do have and cherish those and not try to harbor so much on the bombardment of social media and just what's going on in life. So let's check in on that, on ourselves, check in with each other. Maybe do this with a friend that you guys can like be a sounding board for each other as how the week's progressing. So anyway, always working on ourselves. So again, I'm just reminded, if you have a block, this would be really nice. I do want to do a lot of floor work today, so I'm going to try to have to angle the computer down, and hopefully you can hear me okay. If you had a book, like a really, really thick book, you might be able to use that as another option. Or if you have like a foam roller, you could use a foam roller. But I want to do some back stuff today. Some piriformis, some back, some sacral work. So for now, let's just get nice and comfy. Switch your legs if you need to. Find your seat. If you're in a chair, I want you to also just be mindful of how our spine is, keeping our spine long. So all this work we're doing is gentle and can be in a chair, on the floor, whatever works best. Soften the eye gaze. And you can close your eyes or just soften them, but when you soften or close them, I want you to gently rock, just gently from side to side. It's just like this organic movement. Maybe you can make like a figure eight, just very gentle, very subtle movement, side to side, figure eight. And notice if you feel equal balance on each side. Does one side feel, even in this subtle movement, does one side feel a little tighter? Does one side feel a little more restricted? Maybe you can begin to make that figure eight a little bigger. And in those bigger circles, where do you feel tension or stiffness? Just allowing some organic movement again. You can make figure eights or you can make circles if that feels better. I'm going to bring this down a little bit. Might chop my head off a little. And while you are doing that, just allowing the head, the neck to gently find its rhythm, its motion. Maybe you're going more just side to side. Feel that exhale organically coming out of your body. So these nice big cleansing sighs. So as that negativity may come up through your week, before you say something, maybe you can just do this nice like I'm going to release that thought, that word before I actually say the word. Good. Allow the arms to come up overhead and in a V-like position. Just holding this V position, letting the chest come up. Look up if that feels okay. Try to keep the shoulders dropped down. And relax. Switch the leg position. I'm going to work on our breath now. So remember, anytime we're working on breathing exercises, you want it to be very natural. Don't force your breath. Don't try to restrict it. Just begin to feel like this flow of movement and pattern. So this morning, what I'd like to do, and I want you to even visualize a box almost. So like we're going to inhale on a count of four. So we're going to inhale four. I'll first describe it. Then we're going to pause for four. Then we're going to exhale for four. And then we're going to inhale for four. Hold for four. It's like a box, like a three-sided box. But for some reason, like just having like an image of a line, even a line for one, a line for another, a line for another kind of helps me. So I want to work with that. And then we might move the count to five. So again, the line will be like a five count pause, five count exhale. So again, get comfortable. I just switched my legs. The important thing is to really keep the spine long, soften the eye gaze. And when you're ready, let's inhale. One, two, three, four. Pause, one, two, three, four. Exhale, one, two, three, four. Inhale, one, two, three, four. Pause, one, two, three, four. Exhale, one, two, three, four. Inhale, one, two, three, four. Pause, one, two, three, four. Exhale, one, two, three, four. And take a break for a moment. Begin to just move the hips a little bit, side to side. A little more movement in the torso. See where you feel some restriction. Let the legs come out. Oh, feel that groan and sigh if you need to. Bring your hands on either side. And again, just rocking from side to side. You'll feel the hamstrings, feel the tightness in those hamstrings. Good. And then use your hands to kind of like bring it down one side of the leg, down the other side. So while we're doing this, I actually want you to visualize and feel like I want you to press down the outside of the leg and then come on the inside of the leg. Outside of one leg, inside the other. Outside one leg, inside the other. These are kind of like working just the different meridian points, just kind of massaging them. I believe as I'm learning about meridians more, the gallbladder and the bladder are on the outside. Can't remember what's on the inside. Just kind of going back and forth, just like massaging your legs as you stretch. Giving yourself a little attention. Good. Nice. Walk your hands forward. Go ahead and come on back. Find the position. Now you can stay in this position to do the breath again if you want. If you just feel like that really feels good to stretch your abductor muscles, that's nice. I'll move that back a little bit. See my head? Okay, so let's do that same box, but we're gonna do a 5 count this time, okay? So again, if you feel like a visual is nice, you can do that or just listen to me counting. So again, soften your eyes, make sure that spine is nice and long, creating space in each vertebra. Let the shoulders drop down and let's begin. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pause, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pause, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's do one more round. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pause, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good, and relax. Now you can stay again in that position. You can move into another position. I'm gonna come up onto my knees just to give my quadriceps a little bit of a stretch. Find what works best for you. And then we're gonna take our hands and I want you to put the thumbs like on gently on your temples, very gently. Then we're gonna place our fingertips right in the middle of our forehead. And what I want us to do is begin to just, with some good pressure, not too deep, not too light, kind of start from the middle of the forehead and then work your way across to the temples. Then you come up a little bit, like you're parting your hair in the middle, and then again. And then come up a little bit more to the, maybe the front of the crown. Now your fingers are gonna, your thumbs will naturally kind of come off of the temples as you move higher up. Come to the top of the crown, and like you're creating space in your cranium, in your skull. And then go towards the back a little bit. We're gonna do this twice. This is great for like mental clarity, for grounding. It's like we're creating some circulation in our brain. So keep going. You're going all the way to the back, like where the occipital's right under the, there's an occipital ridge where we hold a lot of tension. And then even go down under the ridge, let your head hang forward and take a couple of strokes here. Like right on the spine, you start at the spine and you're just moving downward. It's like we're allowing some lymph to move as much as we can in our head. Good, so let's try that one more time. So when you're ready, you can start with the thumb on the temples. Okay. And then fingertips and the forehead, press and like creating space, breathing in and exhaling for each movement. And when you're ready, go at your pace. You inhale as you begin to part. And exhale naturally. Go up again, inhaling as you part your skull. Maybe you're at the crown. Work the back of the head, parting the parting of the skull, it's creating space, creating light, creating new, fresh energy. Working all the way to the back, to the neck. And then when you get to the very back where you're at the top of the spine, cervical area, do a couple of different, just start where the spine, at the root, the base of the skull, and just massage downward. This is good for anxiety, stress. It's very calming. Good. Take a moment. Move your head from side to side. Right ear, right shoulder. Left ear, left shoulder. Right ear, right shoulder, chin to chest, left ear, left shoulder, chin to chest. Good. All right. So now I'm going to bring it down a little bit. And I want to take our block, if you have, again, a block or a book or a foam roller or a noodle. And I want to work with this, and I'm going to show you and describe it. And then what you want to do is, if you have the block or a book, try to get it to not the highest level, but like a nice strong base. And then we're going to place that, I'm going to roll on top of it. Let me just make sure, okay, you can see. And if you do have a block, you can see if this is a good indicator for what you want. Eventually, you may want to move it up to the top one. Or again, if you have a foam roller, use a foam roller. Keep your feet hip width apart, bend your knees. I'm not supposed to turn my head, but I'm trying to make sure you can hear me. And just enjoy the way this feels. This is great for people who have sciatica. So what you want to do is allow the hands to be palm up and then rocking, like we're doing that rocking motion, just going side to side, just slowly. And that's massaging the glutes, opening up the piriformis, which often squeezes that sciatic nerve. And if you don't have any of those, then you have tennis balls, grab some tennis balls and put them on either side of the spine and then play with it for a few minutes. Maybe you bring the tennis balls down a little lower. So be creative with the props that you have. Tennis balls are always a good option. So let's take these next few minutes and explore. Just breathe into the spaces where you feel the tightness. Hold that block or ball where you feel like it needs it. Move the block or ball up or down a little bit according to what your body is asking. If you don't have a block, maybe, I know at TJ Maxx, they have them for really cheap, or you could get one online. They're really a good prop to have. Let's take a few more moments, breathing in and out through our nose. Moving our prop up and down our spine. Last few moments, really just navigating where you feel the release. Feels really nice. It's like creating space. It may be a little uncomfortable and tender. So remember to breathe through that. Good. And we're going to let that block or ball or whatever come down away from you. Stay in bridge pose for a moment and then roll your spine down slowly. One vertebra at a time. And just see how that feels. When you lay all the way down, can you feel that your spine is connecting with the earth a little bit more? We're going to bring our left knee in and we're going to press that into our chest. Lift the head up so we can really get more space in that lower sacrum. Take the right leg up. If you can place your hand behind your hamstring and pull it towards you gently. Press the knee back in towards your chest, head towards your knee. And then bring it back down. Bring the arms up overhead. Take a nice inhale, exhale out through your mouth. Bring the arms down to inhale, lift the arms up overhead. Exhale, arms down. Bring the left knee in towards your chest. Let the feet be active. Bring the head up if that feels okay, or you can let the head stay down. Bring the leg straight up, interlace your fingers, and allow the heel to reach toward the sky. Bring the knee back towards the chest, press into the chest. And release the leg down. Bring the arms up overhead. And exhale down. Arms up overhead, inhale. Exhale down. Now this is one of my favorites. I want you to bring your left ankle onto the right knee. Left ankle on right knee. Hold the hand on the ankle for support. You're going to bend that right knee and then bring that left arm kind of as a balancer out to the side. So it should look almost like you're going to do like a figure four. Okay. And then I want you to gently, you're not doing anything but just moving this left foot towards the earth. Move the left foot towards the earth. See if you can place that left foot on the earth. If you're doing this in the chair, you can do the same thing. Cross your ankle over your knee in the chair. And if you can fold forward in the chair as much as you can, you'll get that same kind of sensation. Take the head, if you want, just rotate it towards that left arm. Good. Release that pose. Let's do the other side. We're going to do this twice. So take the right ankle over the left knee. Use the left hand as a support. Use the right hand as a just a balancer. And then begin to bring that right foot over to the left side. Let the head rotate towards the right if that feels okay. Take some nice breaths in. So this is a beautiful twist. Working that muscle that we just focused on with the block, opening up the piriformis. Come on back. And bring your legs down for a minute. Just shake them out. Shake them out. We're going to do that one more time. Shake them out. Make some pitter patter on the ground. Good. And let's do that again. So take the left side, the opposite side, place it on the knee, take the hand as support, and bring that left leg over to the right side. Good. Come on back. And let's do the other side. So we're going a little faster. And come on back. And we're going to do a little core work. So what I want you to do is stay as you are. You see the time. Bring your hands under your buttocks for support. I mean, I like to do it that way. If you're in a chair, you're going to be working on the chair and just bringing your leg up and down. You're going to do one side and then do the other. So for us, we're going to do some leg lifts. So you can start with your knees bent. Bring your knees into your chest. Let the legs come straight up. And then slowly, and if you need to do one at a time, you can. Slowly, we're going to bring the legs down, down, down. I like to put a little bend in them because it's just good on my back. You're going to kind of kiss the toes onto the earth. And then you're going to swoop them in towards you again. Got it? Bring the legs up. Get a nice extension here. You can put a little micro bend as you slowly start coming down. Kind of kiss the ground with your toes. Swoop them back up towards your chest. And the hands give you nice stability on your spine. Let's do a few more. You can go however fast or slow. Slower makes it harder. Two more. Good. Bring your knees into your chest. Rock from side to side. Really rock. Use your elbows to kind of like keep you upright. And now make some nice circles with your knees. Then let the knees go, let the hands go off the knees. And here's another good core work, is to slowly make these circles. So you can exaggerate the circles as much as you want. The bigger they are, the more core work you're gonna do. So try it in one direction. Let's do five. Slowly, big circles. Three, four, and five. Place your feet down. Bend the knees. Lift the hips up. Keep the chin towards the chest. Lift a little higher. Let the shoulders come down towards the feet. Roll the spine down, one vertebra at a time. Let the tailbone touch and then lift up again. Lift the hips up. And then we'll roll the vertebra one notch down each time. Bring the knees into the chest. And then do that same circular motion, but in the opposite direction. So we're creating these big circles, slowly working core, getting those abdominal muscles stronger to protect our back. Keep going. I'm going to do about three more. So three, two, and one. Good. Bring the knees into the chest. Bring the head up to the knees. Let the arms come down by the side. Let the legs come straight up. And we're going to bring the right leg down. We're going to do like switch. And then we're going to bring the right leg up and the left leg down. Left leg up, right leg down. And keep going. Again, if you're in a chair, just alternate legs slowly coming up. Make the movement slow. Few more, might start feeling that now. Switching legs. Just kind of touching the ground. Good. One last one. One last set. Oh. And drop the legs. Bring the feet out each side of the mat as wide as you can. And then drop the knees over to one side. And then drop them over to the other side. And drop them over again. Back and forth. Good. And then slowly take another moment or two, and just any last little movements you want to make. Anything that's just calling you before we get into our Shavasana. So today it was really, with the 45 minute class, it goes by so quickly. But I wanted to do some core work, some calming with the brain, kind of like creating some lymphatic and circulation, kind of working the energy by spiraling, doing our little box frame for our inhale, our pausing and our exhale. So breath work, some calming, some core work, and now some relaxation. If you don't have a block, maybe try to get one if you can. See if some yoga studios are getting rid of some. But the block for the lower back and sacrum is so wonderful. So now get comfortable lying down. Or if you're in a chair, just softening your eyes. Allowing the muscles to release. Allowing the bones to just fall into the earth. Allow the breath to be a little more shallow as far as not working so hard. Just easing the breath. Letting go of any remaining tensions, be it mental, physical. Using that exhale to let it go. The more we can just release those negative thoughts and through our breath, they don't hold into our body. As those negative thoughts, impressions, sensations, restrictions part ways with your cellular body, replace them on the inhale with a positive thought, a positive image, a positive image of a person, It's like you're exhaling the old and inhaling with the new. It's not that we're not honoring our feelings or honoring our emotions. We're just not letting them take over. We're not letting them navigate the way our day goes. We're not giving those negative emotions all of our power. We're just saying, okay, I get you, I see you, and then let them go. As you're here a few minutes more, some things might come up. They're stirring in the subconscious. You can use the power of that exhale, that letting go, so that you can create the internal space through your skull, your brain, your heart, your stomach, to create more positivity, more light. No, it's not easy right now that every day we're challenged. This is our opportunity to accelerate our growth and our potential. Now see as you're exhaling out any remaining negativity, and that's all gone. Notice how maybe you're breathing a little lighter. Maybe there's just a little more space in the heart. Maybe it doesn't feel so hard to take a breath in. So you can remain here if you'd like, just enjoying the benefits of your practice. The stillness. So wherever you are right now, laying down or seated, bring our thoughts for a moment to uplifting each other. Like you're sending a sunburst to someone else, to our community. To our country, to our world. Just send out that sunburst of energy. And thank you all for joining me today. Stay blissful, and I will see you next time. Namaste.